Hello, this is not a spring chicken. The biggest news today is, of course, the economy. Oh, wait a minute. Is economy on track? Wait, there's record sales, the stock market's going up, and oh yes, Obama's got his plan that he's going to reveal in September about how he has more jobs for all of us here in the U.S. Well, for now, we're going to bring Oldecam on with comments on the headlines of today.
There's the blood pressure.
Yeah.
And Obama's bus has cost $1.5 million apiece for his taxpayers' paid campaign trip.
I know, three buses for Obama at $1.5 million apiece. And, you know, he wants to talk seriously about cutting spending and has $5 million worth of buses. And they're talking all of the other things that go with them. They said they're spending like $40, $50 million for his listening tour, which it also includes fundraisers, which makes it a political event. And the problem is that how do you know the Republican upper guard is not serious about cutting anything?
How?
The fact that... Well, all the presidents do this, so we can't be critical of him because he's doing it. They have no intentions of stopping spending, which is why they said this morning, Paul Ryan, who's a deficit hawk and wrote the budget that did get passed, is now considering running for the president. He's been warned by the same people that are after Palin and Bachman that it would not do your career good to run for president.
Oh, really?
Because they don't want to stop spending.
Well, how much do buses normally cost for those?
You can get a good bus like that one of the country singers basically has a tour bus company. He can give you a good bus for about $250,000.
So what is this? These campaign buses are really president buses, so they're bulletproof?
They're bulletproof.
And they're meant for him to do his duties as a president as well as campaign would be my guess.
He's not supposed to campaign in them. Those are government property. He's using government property that were specially built for him. These were not something that just, they weren't in storage. They had them built for this trip.
Oh, no wonder why there's so much.
Yeah, the Republicans that wanted the budget cut are throwing fits. The Republicans that basically passed on any cuts are saying, well, it's all right.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Well, I guess we can tell where they stand now.
And there's going to be a split. I'm guessing... That Paul Ryan will run, and Paul Ryan will head the Tea Party movement because they got to throw him out of the Republicans because they want somebody that basically is going to do what they want, which would be the Romney, who's old enough to be Obama's father, or Perry, who's old enough to be Obama's father. These are entrenched people in the party. So
basically, they want to take over.
Yeah.
Right, the Republicans want to take over, but they want to keep things the same.
They want it to remain exactly the same. That's why leapfrog Obama is out today, folks, because if you elect a Republican, you're going to get more of Obama. You're just going to get Obama in a different direction.
I know. And Warren Buffett's divisive plea, raise my taxes.
But the problem is he's been challenged by people, and he will not. They told him to put his pocketbook where his mouth is. He won't. Well, I know other people have to be involved. He said, I know when the taxes are raised, I'll gladly pay the extra taxes. No, there's a provision in the Constitution, in the tax code, that says if you want to pay more money, you can pay more money. And none of these people do it. Brad Pitt wouldn't do it. Matt Damon wouldn't. You know, these people are unfair. He won't pay any extra himself voluntarily.
Yeah.
Because what happens is, as soon as they pass the legislation, they then figure the loophole that can get around it so they don't actually pay any of the money.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to use leapfrog Obama. Okay, here at B.S. the Bull. Hey, leapfrog, leapfrog, who actually owns the majority of the business in this country that are multi-millionaires and billionaires for real? Democratic Party does. You mean the Republicans own those small businesses? Almost all of them. You mean Democrats are the ones that are not paying their fair share of taxes? That's right.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Well, actually, it reminds me of building nuclear power plants. Everybody thinks they're a good idea and wants them, but they just don't want to do it where it affects them.
Well, but the Democrats always pass, they'll only pass new tax legislation that they know that they talk to their lawyers, and their lawyers will tell you what the loopholes are before they pass the legislation.
Mm-hmm. And Obama to let people know what his new plan is to create jobs in September, which will be unlike his current plan to create jobs.
I know, which is exactly, they said, okay, here's one again last night, they were making fun, okay. One of the comics on the left was making fun. You mean, it's going to be unlike, we have to have a fair and balanced approach, which means if you got it, they're going to take it from you. And we're going to have green jobs, and we're going to get rid of, we're going to have to stop for petroleum dependency on the rest of the world, and then we're going to have to increase health care benefits for the people that are losing them, and we're going to have to increase the payments for the people that aren't getting payments, which makes more employment because then those people jump back on rolls. And we're going to create an infrastructure bank, and then the guy who's playing Obama said, no, it's nothing like that. We're going to create infrastructure jobs. We're going to create green jobs. And he said, but you said exactly. I didn't say it the same way.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I know. You know, it almost sounds like we're going to have a feature on a campaign speak or political speech and its translation for Americans.
Well, but they did say one thing. Virtually everybody on the right and left agreed. You do not have to read what Obama's doing to find out what it is, because they already know it's the same thing he's been on since he ran in 2008. He hasn't changed the speech any.
And SEC launches inquiry into S&P handling on downgrade.
Oh, yeah, because they intend to destroy Standard & Poor's.
Of course they do.
Yeah.
Since they downgraded them.
They said Obama is playing. Okay, here's the trick is, Chicago-style politics do not work on the federal level. They only work on the city level and state level. Once you get beyond that, you're talking about thugs that make the people in. Okay, I can tell you, I can keep trying to explain. My mother is from Cicero, Illinois, folks. In Cicero, they are so mean and nasty, they made Al Capone look like Al Capone was a choir boy.
Mm-hmm.
That's where the big thugs come from, is Cicero. That's where my father's from California, but my father grew up in California with people that were not mean enough to live in Cicero, so they came out here to run the mobs.
And big media's profits defy gloomy outlook for now.
They're not making any money, no matter what. They are not making money. We go into movie theaters every week, and these theaters on these blockbuster movies are not, they're empty. There's nobody there. When you can, you know, go in a few, 10 minutes before the show starts and get a prime seat.
Mm-hmm.
We have seen more people at Emmy screenings than in big budget movies that are making $1 billion.
Actually, we have seen more people in Emmy screenings because all the seats were filled.
Yeah.
And they had standing room.
That's right. They couldn't even get, you know, no popcorn and drinks. It's all, you're there because you wanted to go. So.
And Obama spars with the Tea Party activists at town hall meeting.
Oh, yeah. He said, he basically... here's the people on the right upstairs again. You know, this was irresponsible of that man to talk to the president that way. He said he talked, the lower Republican said he talked to the president exactly as the president. The president is he's a Chicago thug. It's what he called
him. Why, what did he say to him?
He said, I'm sick and tired of you Chicago thugs and Bill and Biden calling us terrorists because we won't kiss your ass. And Obama got mad. And then he also, I think they also followed it up with the bit, if I have any problems, we're all going to know where the problems came from, won't we, Mr. President?
Mm-hmm.
Which basically that's, and he said, by the way, Mr. President, I was born and raised in Cicero, Illinois, if you understand what I mean.
Oh.
Uh-huh.
Actually, that could have gotten
Obama left.
Oh, really?
Because you don't mess with the people of Cicero in Illinois. You do not mess with them. I mean, the mafia does not have anything to do with the people of Cicero.
Really? Yeah.
No, these are people, these are guys that, you know, the nice, friendly type people, the grandpops, the grandmothers. You know, I mean, my mother's mother, when she'd go back to Cicero, would carry basically a police 38 behind her back under her jacket when she walked the streets of Cicero, because if you didn't,
uh-huh,
they didn't think that you were you knew what you were doing.
Uh-huh. An exam cheating scandal hits a U.S. Navy submarine.
Yeah, they cheat to pass tests. That's how it's done.
Oh, you mean that's not just something that happens?
I can guarantee you. I know a guy that ended up as a vice admiral that had memorized all of the test questions and answers before he'd go in to take the test. Because they do the same test again and again.
Well, you know, part of it is if they do the same test over and over, I mean, come on, what do they expect?
Okay, here's the question. Why do men and women join fraternities and sororities?
Oh, is that why?
Because they keep the test on record for every professor in the cruddy college.
Really?
Yeah, you can go and, okay, he said, hey.
I'm just finding that out.
Martell is doing a test today on such and such. And then they'll go, okay, here's the test and here's the answers. Yeah, so that's how it's done. They keep a record. The teachers never change their tests ever.
And a Monty Bubbleism from the Mark Twain of the Animal Kingdom.
But you always know that there's a time to make changes in what you do. The problem is the devil is in when do you actually know when to do it.